no idea.
See what's your name?
I'm Mary Chris.
Okay.
Okay. Give it to her.
All right, guys, we're waiting. They should be starting this weigh in any second right now. The commission's ready. The fighters are all here. Here's look. Amado Vargas, Fernando Vargas. Here's I see the heavyweight. And there you have Regis. There you have everybody over here. They're chilling. I'm good. How are you guys doing? We're here. We're excited. It's a big event. Big turnout. Look, I'll show you guys. Look. It's just a packed house, guys. And everyone's excited. So waiting to go live right now. Guys, if the live feed cuts out, I'm gonna record this on this brand new iPhone, so you're gonna get some good quality stuff regardless. Because I'm afraid that if they go live, we might take a hit over here on the quality. Here, Loma and Saeed. Loma and Haney is the fight everyone's looking forward to. And here comes Beto Duran. He's gonna be doing the announcing. So once he grabs the mic, we know we're in business. Right now, he's not grabbing a mic. It was supposed to start at 1 o'clock, guys. They're running some 10, 15 minutes behind, but that's normal, that's boxing. When you're on time, it starts late. When you're late, it's over. So I've been to weigh-ins where I came in 15 minutes late and it was over. Weigh-ins are very quick. They get on the scale, off the scale. In 1 minute, they're going live, guys. 1 minute. All right, hopefully, cross your fingers, the feed doesn't freeze.
Thank you. Tyson make her watch.
Three, two, one, here we go, guys. This is the weigh-in, and it's official.
Well, hi, friends, a very good afternoon. Welcome to the Hyatt Regency LAX here in Los Angeles, California. We are just about 24 hours away from Battle of the Best, the WBC Super Lightweight World Title on the line, as number one, Jose Zapeda, takes on number two ranked contender, REGIS Rougarou Program. It's all going down tomorrow. In Carson, California, and it is promoted by Marv Nation Promotions and Legends Entertainment. By fans, you can join us for the live action inside of Dignity Health Sports Park. Tickets are available for $39 that remain, and you can purchase those on access.com or at the box office. So let's get this weigh-in started now as we will open up with our first fight. This will be at 3:05 Pacific Standard Time, and it is a featherweight attraction. Six rounds with Terrence Sherman and Jacob Makalolo Oy. First on the stage out of the blue corner, 3-0 with one knockout. Here's Terrence Sherman. And his opponent is to my right, undefeated with two knockouts, three professional victories, Jacob Makalolo Oy. German first on the scale for us. Even for Terrence German. Here's his undefeated counterpart, Jacob Makalolo Oy. 146.8. And this featherweight comes in 146.8. Again, first fight tomorrow, 3:05. Doors will open up at 3:00 at Dignity Health Sports Bar. We'll have five undercard fights for you before a free portion of the televised worldwide event takes place tomorrow. Then, of course, we'll be live on pay-per-view, cable, satellite, telco, and streaming pay-per-view outlets, which do include Fight and pay-per-view.com. Here's your first fight face-off. Two undefeated featherweights will open up the card for us tomorrow. Terrence German and Jacob Makalolo Oy. All right, we're going to bring up our second fight. Middleweight action, eight rounds. With Luis Alberto Vera and his opponent, Eric Priest, undefeated, middleweight. Vera first on the scale, he's ready to go 11-2 and one knockout to his credit.
159.8,
Luis Alberto Vera. His opponent 8-0 with six knockouts. Here is Eric Priest.
Woo! Go Eric!
160 even for Eric Priest, the undefeated middleweight. We'll get Jesus Roman and Austin Brooks ready. You will be next. Roman, his opponent, undefeated out of the red corner, Austin Brooks. Jesus Roman, 8-5 with three knockouts.
129.6.
Official weight, 129.6. 129.6. And here's his opponent, 8-0 with two knockouts, Austin Brooks. 129 Brooks.
Thank you.
Marv Nation Promotions and Legends Entertainment teaming up tomorrow night at Dignity Health Sports Park to bring you the Battle of the Best. This is your third fight here with Jesus Roman and Austin Brooks on a stacked 13-fight card that kicks off at 3:05 Pacific. Thank you, gentlemen. We'll see you tomorrow. Now we'll move to the middleweight division. Out of the blue corner, Geronimo Sacco. His opponent, Mario Ramos. Sacco, 10-6-1 with two knockouts, first on the scale. 150 official, 150 pounds for Sacco. His opponent, Mario Ramos, the undefeated 10-0-8 knockout middleweight. 151.6 for Ramos.
Portion after this. So this, and then comes the pay-per-view.
Ostadio 142.4. His opponents, undefeated Alejandro Reyes. 142.6. Gentlemen, here we go, folks, with our preview action. This will kick off at 5 p.m. Pacific. Featuring out of the blue corner, Eduardo Estela. His opponent, undefeated Ruben Torres. Eduardo Estela, first on the stage. 13-1, 9 knockouts. Estela. Official weight, 136. Here's his opponent, 19-0 with 16 knockouts. Ruben Torres. 136.2 for Torres. Once again, this fight will kick off at 5 Pacific, live worldwide, pay-per-view.com, and fight. Amongst other streaming services, this is your free view version of the pay-per-view tomorrow, brought to you by Marv Nation Promotions and Legends Entertainment. Rounds is in the super bantamweight division with Gerson Ortiz Moraes, his opponent Nathan Rodriguez. Two undefeated super bantamweights will clash tomorrow, the last preview fight before our live worldwide pay-per-view event begins at Dignity Health Sports Park. Here is Gerson Ortiz Moraes, 17-0 with 8 knockouts. 123.8, they are fighting for the Fingerbox Championship in the Super Bantamweight Division. And here's also the other undefeated fighter on this card, Nathan Rodriguez, the Super Bantamweight. And I'm going to be 123.4. Rodriguez, 123.4. Both fighters on weight and ready to go again. This is for the Fingerbox Championship in the Super Bantamweight Division. The last bout on our preview portion of the card tomorrow night in the Battle of the Best. Thank you.
I'm only mad. Just enough support from everybody.
This isn't your weight division. You're going up because you wanted to fight this market, brother. Why?
Hey, man, we got to chase victory, man. Hey, in life, we got to think out of the ordinary, but this is the best. Best position, shout out to Fernando Marley Jr. and Pop, you know, take the thing with you, you know, but it's under the building, we're going to show up, support everybody out there.
Again, a 10-round WBC semifinal. Junior middleweight title eliminator bout. República Dominicana and the undefeated Cleveland, Ohio native Charles Conwell. Pinto, take it away.
Juan Carlos Abreu, Dominican Republic. I can translate Spanish, and when you got game reviews, the last time they were finished, you bring him in. How do you feel? What do you expect?
Me siento muy bien. Hablamos a público y va a ser una buena pelea. No hay mucho que decir. Todo el mundo me conoce. ¿Qué va a decir?
Thank God, thank you for the public for being here. It's going to be a good fight. There's not much to say here. Everyone knows me.
You're taking on an Olympian. Get closer, get closer. Taking on an Olympian, you know what you expect. How much do the media represent the public?
Representaba el país lo de todo, primeramente, y yo sé que lo gozaba los olímpicos, pero esto no es José Omatel, es profesional.
I'm very happy to be representing my country. It means everything to me. I know that he's a boxer with Olympic experience, but this isn't amateur boxing, this is professional boxing. This is a different thing.
All right, you'll see him in the Republic. And when the Dominican Republic, you'll see him on pay-per-view, Juan Carlos Abreu. Gracias, fuerte. All right, now we bring in, from Cleveland, Ohio, 2016 Olympian, Charles Conwell. All right, how are you doing? We talked to you during the media workout this week, the press conference. You know, people have seen you, they know what you can do, but you have a chance to steal the show, don't you?
Oh yeah, for sure. I'm kicking doors, steal all this man, and that's awesome.
I'm Marv Nation putting on the show. You got a lot of people here, but people watching you back home. If they're seeing you for the first time, what are you expecting?
Oh man, you know, I expect dominance and then great performance, man. I'm looking down, I told them to steal the show and a big performance.
Charles Conwell, that'll be the second fight on pay-per-view. We still got our main event to come and more. Joe Martinez, bring it up.
Thank you, Beth. I'd like to thank Andrew Rivas, our Spanish translator, for putting it down for us tonight. We appreciate that. Now, folks, we'll move on to an exciting fight tomorrow. This is a heavyweight thrown down 10 rounds of extra schedule. First up, from Jacksonville, Florida, we have Curtis Harper.
Curtis Harper.
Harper, 1-2-8 with 9 knockouts. 260 pounds for Curtis Harper of Jacksonville, Florida. It is a point. 2020 Olympic gold medalist from Uzbekistan, undefeated, Bakulir Shamanov. 11-0 with 11 knockouts to start his career. 247.6 for the big Uzbek, undefeated, Shamanov. All right, Harper. Jalalov, your heavyweight will face the crowd first for us, gentlemen. Heavyweight action with Curtis Harper of Jacksonville, Florida, undefeated, Bakulir Shamanov, the big Uzbek, gold medalist, undefeated heavyweight from Brooklyn, New York. Facing off tomorrow night on pay-per-view from Dignity Hill Sports Park in Carson, California. All right, let's go get him.
All right, you look at a guy who's 6'7", you guys kept staring at each other. What'd you see? Fought bigger. This ain't nothing new. All right, when you look at him, what you see in his eyes? Small man. So you're not intimidating at all. Presenting Jacksonville, Florida, Curtis Harper coming on through. You'll see him.
All right, main event is next, guys.
2020. Olympic super heavyweight division representing Uzbekistan. Shalom. Alright, first your message to your fans in Uzbekistan.
Assalamu alaikum. Hello everyone. I am glad to see you here. Thank you for coming. Inshallah, I am the champion, inshallah. I am super heavyweight champion. No. Okay.
A lot of said right here, Beth. All right, folks, here we go with our main event tomorrow, a main 10 rounds for the IBF WBO Junior Flyweight Championship of the World. First up, fighting out of Santa Fe, Argentina, the WBO IBF Junior Flyweight World Champion. 17-0-1 with 6 knockouts, La Princesita Harris Haberman, Ben Mullen. One hundred six pounds even for Ben Mullens. And your opponent from San Jose, Costa Rica, 26-2. 9 knockouts to her credit. IBF WBO World Middleweight World Champion, your first day. Defending champ, and Mullen puts the belt on the line tomorrow night, unbeaten as she takes on Yoka Valle, the IBF WBO World Middleweight Champion.
Representing Argentina, fighting for the United States for the first time, how do you feel?
very happy. This is a dream of mine to be able to defend my titles here. I'm ready to give everything in the ring to be a great fight, and I hope that I can come back home with my two titles.
You have two belts. How's it feel to defend your title again? Representing Argentina, WBO, IBF, 180 pounds belt on the line. And now we have from Pura Vida, the Castellano, and this is just like, you're going up in weight. Why? Yokohama is selling out arenas in Costa Rica. I've seen it. They go crazy for her. This was an English she's been practicing. How do you feel?
I raised the point.
Then Mark Ringes from Mark Nation bringing you the women's battle. This is John. That's our co-main. Nacho, do we have the main event?
We do have the main event. Mark Nation and Legends Entertainment bringing it to you tomorrow live on pay-per-view.com and Fight. If you do not have your subscription, make sure you get yourself logged in and set up for our main event tomorrow night. The battle of the best, the super lightweight crown on the line as we will now bring up our fighters for that featured bout. First up, he is from New Orleans, Louisiana, former WBA, WBCO, lightweight world champion, a number two ranked super lightweight contender in the world. Here it is, the region, you got to be proud of that. 23 knockouts, and next is his opponent, 23-0, one draw, 20 knockouts. He's a two-time world title challenger, the WBC's number one ranked contender in the world, from La Puente Gali.
Here, we got everybody here. Our nation fighters from the big, 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 big,
Today,
I'm telling you.
The Golden Girl.
Go viral.
She's going viral.
Yeah.
The Golden Girl.
Check out. These are her shiny light on.
She doesn't need the belt.
She signed by Golden Boy too.
By Golden Boy. There you have it. Definitely stole the show today at the weigh-in.
That's right.
Like Clark Kent, huh?
I just
say
in Spanish. It says también las mujeres pueden.
We can do it. Everyone can do it. So she's doing it big time.
You're gonna see the best version of us as a man. I can tell you that 100%. The experience, all the training.
How are you?
Hey, will that set up that rematch with Jose Ramirez that you've been thinking about for so long?
I'm sorry?
Will that set up that rematch with Jose Ramirez if you're victorious tomorrow that you've been waiting so long for?
It can happen, yeah. Whoever it is, number one in the WBC, that's what I'm going for. But if it's Ramirez, let's do it.
Hey, last question. When can we see you in studio on the Fighters Voice podcast? When can we see you in studio on the Fighters Voice podcast?
My brother.
Champ, how was the face-off?
It was great. It's about time, man. I'm just waiting for tomorrow, man. I'm anxious. I've been training for 3 months, so.
You look in great shape. You're ready. You're excited. Did you tell him anything? Did he tell you anything?
No. The partners did that for us. I keep saying it. This is the best version of Jose Zapeda. Tomorrow you're gonna see something. The best version of me. So you gotta keep an eye.
You had a lot of fans here today. Did that surprise you?
No, I'm actually fighting my hometown, so it didn't surprise me. I'm glad that everyone's here, and I thank them.
My last question: you're fighting in 24 hours. What's your routine for the next 24 hours?
Rest a lot, eat, rest, and watch some legendary fights.
Like which?
Leonard Hagler. Pacquiao Morales, the first one, all these kind of fights. Where
get you in the right mood. Yep.
Right.
All right, there you have it. Thank you. Thank you. You guys got the biggest cheers over here.
I know. It's great the support that we got going on, man.
It's exciting.
And you know what's crazy? You know, my brother doesn't say this on the camera. I was like over like 8 ounces yesterday. He was already on weight. I was putting on my plastics. He's like, bro, I'll run with you. And it's like, you know, the camera is all good. Like he said, you know, we're the dynasty. We're always doing this. together, but when it comes to rhythm, when it comes to it, my brother was there and rowing me, and I love this guy in there. We both made weight, but tomorrow's his time, Mr. Vargas Dynasty, and tune in, it's going to be a good card.
I'm going to tell you guys what impressed me more than the boxing. You went to the homeless shelter, Skid Row. You're making weight. All the fighters were invited. You're the only fighters to show up, and then you went running afterwards. But you did something incredible. You inspired people that are in the toughest moment of their life. Tell me about the experience being there and giving like 2,000 meals.
You know what's crazy is everyone gets active right during Thanksgiving and Christmases, but you know, I haven't done it in a while where I've reached out to someone, because you can get caught up in your own agenda, your own career, what you got going on. You know what, it was a really a good thing for us to be out of our comfort zone. Yes, we got to wait. Yes, we're cranky, we're moving, we got to fight. But that's Saturday, and Thanksgiving, it was just something that missed. Like, hey, you have an opportunity to go to the homeless shelter. And we're like, let's go. So that's what we're about. We're about family and we're about giving back.
Sayy, did you hear what they did yesterday? They gave out, they went to the worst homeless shelter in downtown. They gave away 2,000 meals and they donated $12,000.
I know, I've seen that.
Amazing.
That's what good people do, brother. And never forget where you're from. They said, if you don't know where you're going, never forget where you're from. And these kids know exactly where they're from. That's why we love them. That's why we come from here. That's why we got to support them. And we want to get behind them.
Say, he's great. Hey, you got to put them in some movies.
Man, this guy right here with the curls, I think we can do it.
I got to talk to Saeed. You put me in with him.
We got
to
get past Saturday first.
We got to get past Saturday.
Absolutely.
And, you know, shout out to all the kids, the homeless people, because that's what it's about. You know, it's not about us. It was about them that day.
Yeah.
You know, now, this Saturday, we got to fight. We got big people supporting my man Saeed. You know, Eggis Climas, Jose Dela Cruz.
There's a lot of amazing fighters. But then when a good fighter meets a good human being,
amazing. Listen, they were the only fighters to show up because every fighter was invited. They're the only ones to make it. And they will make it wait. They weren't running afterwards. They're hungry. They're grouchy.
We all know that boxing is not an exact science, but best is yet to come.
That's true. All right. Tell everyone where to follow you. And the last thing, your prediction for the main event tomorrow, guys.
It's tough, but I'm going to go with my guys to pay them. I got to go with them.
REGIS, that's my boy too. It's gonna be a tough one. Man, I can't wait to see the fight. It's the best fighting the best. Let's go.
There you have it. Thank you so much. Good luck tomorrow. Do your thing. Elie Seckbach reporting.
Can you do a video for my friend?
Sure.
His name is Zach.
Zach, I got you.
You already did one for me in Fresno.
We'll do another one.
That whole cess fight.
All right, let's do it. All
right. 1, 2, 3.
What's up, Zach, man? You're missing a fight of the year. You better be here tomorrow, man. Everybody's asking about you. They're looking for you. Zach.
Thank you, bro.
How you feeling? Good. Egis, can I ask you a couple quick ones really quick? Lomachenko Haney, is it done yet?
No, it's not done.
Almost done?
Working.
Well, we're excited about it. It's a big one.
It's a big
one. And then Amado Vargas, Fernando Jr. fighting on this card. Tell me about that. Big opportunity on a pay-per-view.
Very big. Very big. Especially Jr. being on the TV showing fight. So it's going to be broadcasted around the world. As far as I hear it, so going to be good. Going to see what's the result.
And what's the update on Usyk and Fury? Any word? I heard late February, Saudi, maybe early March.
Got my tickets to go to London.
Is it going to be in London now? Or are you going to see December 3rd you're going?
No, we're going December 3rd to London. Hopefully, I finalize.
Well, we know who's going to win. But any message to Loma fans if they're watching?
They watch it, of course. You know, let's support Loma. Let's get that fight done with the Haney. The big, huge fights. That's what we want.
Do you know when it's going to happen, if it happens?
No, we don't know yet. Depends, you know, how the deal is going to end up, when it's going to be ended up. Is that the Mideast? Is that the United States? We don't know. We don't know yet.
But I do know one thing. Loma really wants those belts. That's what he wants, opportunity to be undisputed.
It's course, he does, but every fighter, it's a dream to become undisputed.
And my last question, what do you think about Emmy Vargas? Emiliano just had a huge knockout, top rank.
Oh my God, he did a statement, huh? He did a statement.
He looked great.
Yeah. He's, I think, in my opinion, he's a huge, huge upcoming star.
All right, there you have it. And here you have the one and only Saeed in the house. Stay tuned. Thank you, EGIS. Elie Seckbach reporting.
Gangsters.
Doing their thing.
It's one of the best camera of the day. Wow, this is serious. You can do a movie there.
The lenses are nicer than the
camera. Yeah, I know. You can do a movie out here.
So I'm just showing you some of the behind the scenes over here, guys, so you get a little flavor of what's going on. It's a great fight. The fans are the winners, man. I'm happy you're here.
Hey, fight it this way.
How's it going? All right, so coach, the weigh-in is done. They both made weight. We have a fight. Let me get you in the light. I can see your face. What's the key to victory? Well, I mean, it's an exciting fight. Regis and... What are the odds, do you think, for this fight? Is it 50-50? Is it 45?
No, I think he should be a good favorite. I think Cepeda's a real guy. He's not, you know, he's dangerous, he can punch, he's sharp.
You have to respect him.
Of course, 100%.
What was it like to be on stage? Because the face-off was very tense. They didn't talk to each other, but you could feel the energy.
Yeah, definitely. Hold on, right? They're both ready. It's going to be a good fight. Just gonna smash it.
We're 24 hours away. What's your routine for the next 24 hours? Do you watch nonstop tape of Zapeda?
I watch a little bit. I've been watching nonstop tape. I watch a little bit tonight.
And that's it. And then you relax. And you've been here before. It's not your first rodeo. What do you tell all Regis fans?
I've tried a couple times.
Many times.
When it comes down to it, it's going to come down to it. We got the dog in him. And Regis' name is Rubber, so... That's what's going to happen.
I heard somebody's fighting BKB very soon. Have you heard about that? What do you think about that? It's very dangerous. Hey, if you could do you have experience street fighting?
Absolutely.
Yeah, but you're like the nicest guy. I would never see you jaywalking. You're a great fighter.
It happens.
Y'all just don't know.
No, we don't.
I don't have no idea. He is a super nice guy. What a nice guy I know.
Always has been.
Very good.
Absolutely.
So, okay. Let me ask you this. Austin, you fought Canelo. Canelo says he wants a tune-up. Huh? You say he says you got robbed. How do you feel about that?
Yeah.
Why? Get a little closer.
Yeah. I mean, it's that's the fight that I just can't stand. It was a great fight. We almost had it. Just close. I thought I had that
job. He's a great fighter. You're a great fighter. What do you think Canelo does in a rematch with Bivol?
That's a tough guy.
He's like hard to me. Like, he's a guy who's just not going to take chances. He's super smart. He can punch. He's fast. He's super dangerous. I didn't like to fight him again.
I don't know, man. I don't think that's a good fight for Canelo to take.
He can make plenty of fights that he can win that are very interesting. I think he's just leaving the ball alone.
Okay, let me ask all you guys over here. Gervonta Davis, Ryan Garcia. Break it down. You're a southpaw.
He's like a little Mike Tyson in there. I don't know if Ryan can take any of that pressure. I know Tank can take it. I've seen it in the gym. I've seen it in the box. You got him in the ring. You know, that's a lot of adversity that Ryan has seen.
What do you guys think?
I got Tank.
I think it's a great fight. Tank, I don't think Tank gets credit for the way he sets things up. His timing, and he's going to close his bump. I think Ryan Fairbairn.
I agree. It is a dangerous fight for both.
Yeah, Good fight. Good for boxing.
Okay, Hayden Loma.
I think Hayden, but I'm not like to me like Loma's got more of a chance to win too, style wise.
Okay, what about Benavidez and Plant?
I like Benavidez too.
Okay, you fought at the highest levels. Spence or Crawford?
I'd say Crawford. Well, they even stop waiting.
Well, Crawford's fighting December 10 against a Benicio, which is not an easy fight.
Yeah, it's not
but easy. I think it's not easy, but he wins.
Yeah.
And Spence next. What do you think?
Crawford. I'm always Crawford.
Why?
Smarter fighter. Great IQ.
He has good setup.
No, I'm not saying
that. He's got good. He gets you in trouble, he's gonna get you out of there. But it's just the same defense and great fight. That's why we want to see it.
Because then say it's sold on Crawford, and then I saw Spence from you guys down.
Yeah, it's a good one. Okay, I gotta ask you guys. I posted on Instagram and Oscar De La Hoya commented. I said, because Chavez Sr. told me that at 135 he beats Floyd, at 140 Floyd beats him. And then Oscar said, I beat Mayweather, I didn't beat Mayweather, Castillo Mayweather, and Zab Judah, Mayweather should have been disqualified because Roger ran in the ring.
That's true. I agree with the last one.
I'm just happy with the first one. They don't have the energy, the hunger for the it's hard to pick one. To do BKFC, it's smaller gloves or no gloves. Is there any small gloves? No gloves. Why? Why do it? Brothers undefeated in boxing. But also, where do people?